Hi, I'm Joy, and I want to tell you about my girl, Riley.
Look at her. She was so happy. I mean, I guess I had something to do with that. Not to brag or anything.
You see, I was always Riley's busiest emotion, but then Riley went to grad school. And things, well, they're a little bit different now. So, I need to introduce you to Riley's other feelings.
There's no way we can do all of that reading. We need to cry.
This is sadness. She helps Riley stay grounded in reality, but can get a little carried away sometimes. From then on, things got even more complicated.
All right, another beautiful day for school.
School? Wait, did we forget the assignment for today? The professor can fail us.
Okay, it's okay, Fear. We'll just make sure to check that it's in our backpack.
What if it fell out?
That's Fear. He's always thinking about the worst thing that could happen.
See, it was there the whole time. Now we're gonna be late to class.
What? That's the next worst thing!
He comes in handy now and then, I suppose.
A whole lunch for only 39 cents? What a deal! Wait a minute.
Then there's disgust.
What is that? You're not eating that more than twice a semester.
Disgust keeps Riley from being poisoned by the kinds of food we can actually afford.
And then there's anger. Let's just say that anger has a bit of a hard time with grad school.
So for the final exam, just a reminder, just a gentle reminder that there will be 5 essays, and don't forget to show your work in every single essay.
Did he just say he'd give us 5 different essays?
So that's how you want to play, old man! All right!
Okay. So we've been learning to work together and figure things out. We did lose surprise somewhere along the way.
Breathe!
But aside from that, it's been working out. Riley has even gained new islands of personality along the way. There's naively optimistic expectations of success island, and there's hardworking island. Oh, and my favorite, goodwill toward everyone island.
So overall, we're doing A-okay. And now we're excited to see what third year brings.
Dear students, this will be my last year at Wheaton, as I'm going to be leaving to take a new position in Boston.
Can we not get 5 minutes of peace in this place? Don't they see we have office hours?
No, I think we should see who it is.
Hi, Dr. Davis. How's it going? Sorry to bother you, but I was had a question. It was really just a small question, but well, it's kind of important though too. And I was just wondering if, well.
Oh no, we're rambling! It's in front of Dr. Davis!
There's no way he's gonna say yes to us. We're making a complete fool of ourselves.
This is why we don't have friends anymore.
Joy, do something!
Okay, do something! Okay, don't worry, everyone. I've got this.
I just wanted to say that I really enjoyed working with you in lab, and I think you're pretty great, so I think things would just work out really well.
What are we, asking him out on a date? Just get to the point, here.
Sir, are you gonna chair my dissertation or what?
What was that?
Well, I don't know. You try something.
Okay.
I mean, obviously none of the other professors are qualified enough to know what they're talking about, so that pretty much leaves you.
Excuse me?
Can you believe this? Another student wanting us to chair their dissertation? Do you know how many publications we have to churn out this year, Princess?
This is horrible. I think it's time for some catastrophizing.
Please don't say no. I don't know what I might even do if you weren't my chair. I might have to drop out of the program and live in my parents' basement and play with mice.
I'm not sure why he agreed, but amazingly, he did, and we were on to creating the dissertation proposal. It took a little longer than we expected. Naively optimistic expectations of success Island was the first to go. Next was hardworking Island.
What's the point in this? Our chair's just gonna have us change it more anyway.
We have not showered in days. There's mold growing in the kitchen sink at home.
It's probably black mold. We'll be dying in a week from dysentery.
At least then we'd be free from the tyranny of Davis the Terrible.
Come on, guys, just think of the positive. We still have our imaginary boyfriend waiting for us when we get home.
I would die for Riley.
Too bad he's imaginary.
Oh, hey, Riley.
Oh, hi.
How's it going?
I'm fine.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, I'm great, amazing, fabulous. I don't really know why my voice is this high, because really, I'm fine.
Hey, well, I mean, don't let the pressure get to you. There's only a couple weeks left in the semester. Oh, you're gonna do great.
Huh.
Oh, hey, Sarah.
Hey.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. How's the new job going now that you're done with school?
Oh, it's great. It's so amazing getting a paycheck every week. It's like the best.
I know. Tell me about it. My clients are paying me in straight cash.
Straight cash?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Woo! And all this free time now?
Oh, yeah.
Awesome, right?
I Netflix.
Like, no
I chill.
Yeah.
Oh,
just like the best.
Come on!
So long, goodwill toward everyone, Island.
Our classmates thought we might put our heads together and practice our proposal presentations on one another. Sadness said it was one of those too little, too late things.
Guys, we are not at all ready for these presentations.
What are we gonna do?
I say we just stare at them like they have food sticking their teeth. Maybe they'll be self-conscious and not be paying close attention.
Oh, I have an idea. Maybe if we just cry and wallow and wail, the professors will take pity on us and just pass us on to avoid further fracturing our delicate egos.
We could just not show up.
No? What do you think, Anger?
I don't know what y'all are worried about. My arguments are very well prepared.
Or we could all just do a really amazing job and they'll have no choice but to recognize our potential and...
And they'll have no choice but to recognize our potential and pass us all.
So in conclusion, as long as you choose Chick-fil-A or Polynesian, it means that you have an ambitensive coping style for your personality.
I wonder what the professors are feeling.
Oh, give me a break, Riley. 150 pages and no restorative justice? You didn't even cite Paola Freire.
Oh my gosh, Riley, I'm so distracted. I'm so over this. I can't even listen to you. All I can think of is that students are, again, renewing their assessment materials through the library instead of through me. So over it.
Great. Thank you, Glenn. If you step out.
Okay. I can't watch!
All right, come on back in. Okay, thank you so much, Gwen, for that. And we'd just like to inform you that...
Yeah.
Guys, aren't we glad that we did all of this first year?
Mm-hmm. Let's remember to be humble about it, though. Okay, guys? Be humble.